Hi everybody, you are welcome to this channel Ascend Education and Skills. I am Atanu Betal and in this video lecture we discuss about an important question, answer of the important question, that is the carbon tetrachloride or CCl4 do not get hydrolyzed, but the silicon tetrachloride means SiCl4 is easily hydrolyzed. Why? Easily hydrolyzed in presence of water, why? So this is the topic of discussions, that carbon halides does not get hydrolyzed, but silicon, germanium halides, they easily get hydrolyzed. In case of the group 14 elements, the carbon halides do not get hydrolyzed, no action in presence of water, but silicon halides hydrolyze in presence of water. Okay, so this is the topic of discussions. We discuss about why carbon tetrachloride does not get hydrolyzed, but silicon tetrachloride easily get hydrolyzed. Before starting these discussions, I would like to remind you that if you are new to this channel or you do not subscribe this channel, then you can subscribe it now. Okay, the discussion is about this. We start from the carbon tetrachloride. Okay, in case of carbon tetrachloride, the carbon atom has no vacant d orbital on it. As a result, in the first step of the hydrolysis, water attacks to the carbon atom. This step is does not form in case of carbon tetrachloride. But in silicon tetrachloride, we can draw this situation. In SiCl4, what happens in SiCl4, the water molecule can attack to the central silicon of SiCl4 to form this one. In SiCl4, this water molecule can attack to the silicon atom due to the presence of vacant d orbital on silicon atom. On silicon atom, due to the presence of vacant d orbital, the water molecule attack to the SiCl4 silicon and extend its valency from 4 to 5. In this case, the valency of the silicon compound is becoming 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, in the first step, the water molecule attack and valency extension occur. And after that, in the second step, this HCl molecule removes and this chlorine atom remove with hydrogen and SiCl3OH is formed. After that, in the second step, again one water molecule attack to this silicon and another chlorine will remove and OH is substituted in the place of chlorine. Similarly, the other two chlorines will be substituted by OH and HCl is formed as the byproduct. Okay, HCl gas, hydrogen chloride gas is formed as the byproduct. So, the hydrolysis mechanism of SiCl4 is like this. The water molecule attack to the silicon and forming a intermediate type compound SiCl4OH H2O. Then from this compound, the hydrogen and chlorine is removed as hydrogen chloride gas and SiCl3OH is formed. So, in case of CCl4, in case of carbon tetrachloride, this attack of water molecule is not possible because carbon have no vacant d orbital. So, as a result, in the first step of the reaction where the valency extension occur from 4 to 5, it is not possible by the carbon tetrachloride because here the maximum covalency of carbon is 4. So, it has no vacant d orbital, and as a result, the carbon tetrachloride cannot form the first step of the hydrolysis. First step of the hydrolysis cannot be formed by carbon tetrachloride because of the absence of d orbital in carbon atom. In silicon tetrachloride, the silicon atom has vacant d orbital. Due to the presence of vacant d orbital, in the first step of hydrolysis, water molecule attack and the five valency compound is formed, and after that HCl is removed and this silicon compounds SiCl3OH is formed. And after that, in the second step, third case, what happens? This SiCl OH, this molecule again attack by water molecule to form the SiCl2OH group replace the chlorine atom of SiCl4. After that, in the next step, another chlorine atom will be replaced by OH group. In the next step, the another chlorine atom of SiCl4 replaced by OH group. So, in SiCl4, the hydrolysis by water is possible due to the presence of vacant d orbital on silicon, and due to the presence of vacant d orbital of silicon, silicon can extend the valency from 4 to 5 in the first step of the hydrolysis, that is attack by water molecule. But in case of carbon tetrachloride, the carbon cannot extend its covalency from 4 to 5. So, due to the lack of vacant d orbital, carbon tetrachloride cannot get hydrolyzed. This is the point of discussions, topic of discussions. I discuss it. If you find this discussion is useful for you, then you can like this discussion. And if you find this channel is useful for you, then you can subscribe this channel.